Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You guys know. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
One more time. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, the reason I would give you these tracts is that I'll teach you how to read. But, listen, you got to let me give them. You guys press. You guys, how about line up? Line up. Line up. Line up. Line up. Line up. Straight line. Straight line. Straight line. Straight line. God made you. There's a reason he made you. And Satan wants to come and lie to you. The witch doctor wants to lie to you. Demons want to lie to you. But Jesus Christ comes and tells you the truth. The truth about life. The reason of life. How God is the meaning of life. Everything in Jesus Christ is life. Jesus Christ is the creator of life. Jesus Christ is the beginning of life. Jesus Christ is the meaning of life. Jesus Christ is the meaning to life. The reason for life. Oh, when you have Jesus Christ, you have life. Oh, abundant life. Oh, not because you come to Jesus for more tomatoes. Oh, you don't come to Jesus to bless your life. You come to Jesus to bless his life. Because you were created for him. Now when you bless the Lord, he might give you more tomatoes. But that's not the reason you come to God to get more tomatoes. Because God knows that more tomatoes won't satisfy you. He knows what you need. Everything you need is in your heart. You need a miracle to take place inside you. You do not need a miracle of more onions. You don't need a miracle of more money. You don't need a miracle of more pleasure. Oh, you need a miracle of being born from above. When Jesus Christ comes into your life, and there is a satisfaction beyond words. There's a satisfaction beyond more onions or tomatoes. There's a hope of eternity. There's a hope of another earth. That God has an inheritance for you.
Yes,
oh, what is your inheritance? My Father God has an inheritance for me. Oh, not my earthly father. Oh, maybe some of you have an inheritance on this earth. That maybe if your mother dies, you inherit her tomatoes. Oh, I'm talking about inheritance when you die. You're gonna die. You are living to die. Death can happen any moment. You are a heartbeat away from the judgment seat of God. That means your heart can stop beating right now. My heart can stop beating right now. What would you do? What would you do if you died right now? Are you ready? Is Jesus Christ your Lord and Savior? Are your sins forgiven? This is the most important question in your entire life. Oh, it's more important if you're going to have food tonight. Hey, what's more important? If you're going to have food tonight to eat, or if you died right now and you spend eternity in heaven or hell? Do you understand what I'm talking about? Do you understand that it's appointed on the man once to die and then judgment? Do you understand we are just a vapor that appears for a little while and then we vanish? We're not that great people. We're not that important. We make too much of ourselves. We need to think more about Him. We need to magnify Him. We need to praise Him. Less of me, more of Him. Less of you, more of Him. Oh, many of you, your eyes are on your onions. They're on what your needs are. But when you put your eyes on Jesus, you will never see the righteous begging for bread. He takes care of His children. He promises it. God promises it. God never lies. If you do not believe it, you call God a liar. Oh, I don't want to call God a liar. You know that's what unbelief is. Unbelief is calling God a liar. When you do not believe, God will take care of your needs. You call him a liar. Oh, let us not call God a liar. Let's have faith. Do you have faith as a mustard seed? Oh, if you just have faith as a little grain of sand. Oh, you do great and mighty things for God. I hope you know Him. I hope you're ready to meet Him. I hope you're born again. Don't be religious. Don't be religious and go through the motions. Have a living relationship. Something that is overflowing in your life. Jesus said, from the innermost being.
Yes, anana kuti kuchokera mukati mwainu.
Rivers of living water.
Kasupe wa madzi ya moyo.
That means you're never thirsty.
Kuapa chione sabuti nusu
dzakandiru.
Kuti Mulungu azakutirisa inu.
Oh, that means you drink from that river.
Yes, chitanda zoti munzamo kasupe.
Oh, you experience that river.
I have
a testimony. I experience that river every day.
Every
day, God is faithful to feed me. Oh, I'm not talking about eating an onion. Oh, I'm not talking about bad breath. Oh, I'm talking about spiritually. You are made of spirit, soul, and body. That's